Hello, my name is Sean Lewis. I'm a motivational speaker. I believe I have a message that will inspire and encourage the world, and I want to take it to as many people as I can. I'm 29 years old, from Tulsa, Oklahoma. I have cerebral palsy, but I don't let my cerebral palsy define who I am, what I'm about, or whether or not I can accomplish my goals and dreams or not, and neither should you. I don't care what kind of challenge you face in life, whether it's a disability or some other kind of challenge. God has a purpose and a plan for each one of us, and I believe what He called me to do is motivate and encourage people to achieve their dreams and goals and to see what's possible. You know, we all have a purpose. We all have a dream. We all have a destiny, as I was saying. I have cerebral palsy, but I don't let it define who I am, what I'm about, or whether or not I can accomplish my goals or dreams or not. And the reason I said that again is because I want you to get that point. God didn't put me in a chair. Everything bad comes from the devil. Everything good comes from God. The reason I have cerebral palsy is because the doctor made a mistake when I was born and didn't take me cesarean section like he should have. But so God didn't put me in a chair. This chair is not God's ultimate plan for me. I believe in the manifestation of God's healing, and I believe one day that I will be healed before I leave this earth. Now, I believe that all things work together for those, for the good of those who love God. Not that God caused my situation, but my gift is what I've been able to do in spite of my situation. I can't read, I can't write, with the exception of my name, but by the grace of God, I was able to graduate high school with a 4.0 GPA. I did all my book reports orally, did all my tests orally, and I had to memorize everything. I had an assistant that went to school with me to help me get my textbooks out and read to me assignments on the board. And when I had to take a test, my books were either read to me by my mom or they were put on tape. Me and my mom spent many nights up all night. I dictated papers to her all the way through college and high school. You know, I had a normal high school experience and a normal school experience because I was raised to not let my challenge define who I was or set me on the sidelines of life. You know, I might have to go about things a different way, but I still can do pretty much the same thing you can do, just in a different way. I have the same thoughts, feelings, and emotions that you do. I love to go to concerts, love to go to movies, love to hang out with friends, love to work out, love to, go to restaurants. And I'm very active in my community. I bowl on two leagues. I'm very active in my church. I go to church on the move here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And when I was in school, I went to all the school dances. I went to both my eighth grade prom and my senior prom. Of course, I love music. And if you're a typical guy like me, you love to dance with the ladies. Now I know you're thinking, Sean, how do you dance? Because no, I can't dance in the typical way. But you know what? I can take my wheelchair out on the floor and move it around and slow dance with the girls that way and take them by the hand and do stuff like that. You know, it's not about your disabilities. It's about your abilities. I want you to start focusing on your abilities rather than your disabilities. You know, but when I graduated high school, I knew I just didn't want to sit around and eat macaroni and cheese all my life. I wanted to go to college and make something of myself. I wanted to, you know, add value to the world. I got saved when I was 5 years old, but I rededicated my life at 15 years old. When I was 15, God called me to be a speaker. Originally, I thought this was to be in youth ministry, but after continued prayer, after high school, I went, God showed me that He wanted me to take my message of inspiration and encouragement across all platforms, not just inside the four walls of a church. So I go to colleges, schools, community organizations, businesses, corporations, graduations, anyone that needs a speaker, I'll come. I am a Christian. All my beliefs and my principles are shaped by my walk as a Christian. But I believe that all people, no matter what their background or their faith, can be inspired by my motivation and principles. And I can tailor my presentation to your event. I guarantee you that if you bring me in, your people will not only be inspired, but will be encouraged to achieve their own dreams and goals. Because, you see, it's not about, I don't ever want to hear you say, I can't do that. What you should say is, what do I need to be able to do? What do I need to be able to do that? Not, I can't do that. I can't read. I can't write. With the exception of my name, I have S-calculus, which is the inability to read. My brain doesn't process the words as words. So what do? I love to read fiction, non-fiction, business, leadership books, and, you know, all different kinds of stuff, but I can't read. So I get them on CD, or I have a Kindle that has text-to-speech, and they read it to me, or my mom reads it to me. You know, like I said, I wouldn't be the man I am today without my mom in my corner. My mom is a great example of determination and resilience to me, and a great example of a fighter. See, I saw my dad every other weekend. And I got along with my dad. my dad okay, my dad and I don't fight or fuss, but my dad is not a Christian, and I am. So we're on a lot of different levels and wavelengths as far as a lot of different stuff. Now he respects what I believe, and he understands, and he's proud of me. He respects what I believe, and he understands, and he's proud of me. But he's not ready to come to the decision to accept Christ yet. And my dad was a race car driver for 30 years. He remarried after him and my mom divorced when I was 2. So for a lot of my life, my dad had always had his own thing going on, been focused on his own life. And it took a long time. My dad knew me because I saw him almost every weekend. But he really didn't know me growing up, and in a lot of ways still doesn't know me now. You know, as far as what I can accomplish, what I can achieve. Now he's starting to. Now don't misunderstand me. My dad loves me, but as far as the person that was there for me on my day-to-day, everyday life, helping me with everything I needed to do, people, someone I would go to for advice, that was my mom. My mom helped me with everything, made herself available to take me to all the activities I wanted to do, whether it was to hang out with friends, whether it was to go to dances, whether it was whatever. My mom did that. I was in wheelchair martial arts for a while. I was in Boy Scouts for 5 years. I've been canoeing in the Florida Everglades. So you see, it's about taking something that you want to do and finding a different way to do it. When I graduated school, I wanted to go to college, but I couldn't read, I couldn't write. But they found a degree that I could get with the substitution of some other courses that would allow me to still do what I wanted to do and be able to substitute the courses I couldn't do. So in May of 2007, I got my degree in Human Services and Applied Sciences, and since then I've been using it in my motivational speaking. You know, God doesn't place any limits on you. The limit, and the only limits you have are the limits you place on yourself. If you believe you can, then you can. But if you believe you won't, and you believe that long enough, guess what? That's a self-fulfilling prophecy. And because you're prophesying that over yourself, and whatever you believe, that will come to pass. So what I want you to do is I want you to stop saying to yourself, I'm fixing to do this. I'm fixing to do that. You know the difference in successful people and non-successful people? All it is the successful people are willing to take action, where a lot of people won't. It's failure to make a call, failure to tell that person I love you, failure to put your resume in for that job interview. And, you know, I want you to succeed. I want you to win in life. I want you, if my story can inspire you and encourage you to go after your dreams, I want you to do that. I want you to quit saying, but this, but that. If anybody has a reason to say that, if I want to, it's me. But you know what? That doesn't solve anything. So quit doing that. Get off your butt and make your dreams happen. If it's a girl you want to talk to, quit thinking about it. Go talk to her. Get a number. Just go right up to her. Because the worst someone can say is, no, I can't, I'm sorry, whatever. If they do that, you're no worse off than you were. But if they say yes, whether that's in business, whatever that is, then you're right where you want to be. All you need is 20 seconds of insane courage. Just take a deep breath and go for what you want. Stop saying, but I can never do that because of this. You know what? You are the master of your own destiny. God wants you to succeed. But guess what? Even though he's given you all these talents and abilities, if you don't believe you can, then you won't even try. Take the limiter, take the governor off your life, and live big and live with passion. And, you know, break your dream down into what you want to do. Do you want to become a motivational speaker? Okay? First, you got to figure out what your message is. And then, you got to contact people, let them know you'd like to speak. Then you got to create a bio. And then you go talk to people and keep talking to people. Do you want to be a doctor? Okay, first you got to finish 4 years of college and then apply to the best medical school you can. And then decide what kind of doctor you want to be. Because if you specialize in something, that's going to take more time and more training. Do you want to be a teacher? Find out what you need to be. Do to be the best teacher you can. Read books on teaching. Read books on how to connect with other people. Do some search on Google on where the best way to be a teacher is. Do you want to be an entrepreneur? Do you want to start your own business? Okay, read books on how to do that. Think about what you already have and then turn that into a business. Are you good at planting plants? Are you good at, you know, design? Get yourself some business cards and make up a business card for yourself. Put an interior designer on it. Do you want to start an online store? Decide what kind of products you want to sell, what kind of service you want to provide, and then open up an Amazon store, use Craigslist or something like that. There's any number of ways you can do it. And many of you might say, but Sean, I don't know what I want to do. Whatever you love to do, whatever gets your juices pumping in the morning, that's what you're supposed to do. Whatever you would do for free for the rest of your life, that's a good indication of where your passion is. And don't follow money. Follow what you're passionate about. Follow what's in your wheelhouse. Everyone has a sweet spot. Find that sweet spot for you, and the money will come. A lot of us, God has given us skills and abilities in multiple areas. Besides being a motivational speaker, God's given me a passion to have an online store. So I'm working on building that. You know what? I haven't arrived everywhere I want to get in my life, but I'm always a work in progress. But every day, if you work towards 1% of what you want to achieve in your life, what is that over a year? That's not 1%, because that 1% will stack on top of each other. But if you keep growing, you'll eventually get to where you want to get. And you can do it. I believe in you. If you want to do it bad enough, you can do it. But you got to believe you can. And you got to be willing to work hard. And you got to be willing to put in the dedication, the time, the practice, whatever. And the greatest investment you can make is the investment in yourself. You know, like I said, I'm not everywhere I want to be, but guess what? I continue to study. I continue to grow. And, you know, you should want to be a lifetime learner. Many of you might have graduated school a long time ago, but use life as education and share with other people what you know. Help someone else achieve your dream, achieve their dream, and guess what? You'll achieve yours. If you'd like to find out more information on how to book me, you can find that at Sean, S-E-A-N, G-O-D-S, God's Man, M-A-N, @gmail.com. I'm also on Twitter under the same name. And I also have a Facebook page, Sean Lewis Motivational Speaker on Facebook. And I also have another YouTube channel where I review books, movies, and music, and entertainment, and fun things I think people should check out and see and do, as well as videos of me living my life. And I hope this channel inspires you and encourages you like never before to go after your dreams. If you like this video, don't forget to leave your comments at the bottom, subscribe, tweet it, post it, share it with all your friends, and have a wonderful day. God bless you. Don't forget, dreams are what life is made of, but you are the only one to make your dreams happen. God bless, and I'll be looking forward to hearing from you soon. Oh, yeah, and if you have any questions about my disability or anything like that, or if you think there's something I can help you with there, please keep your questions respectful, but I'll be happy to answer you. And, you know, I'm going to just say this up front. You know, a lot of people ask me, do I want to have a family? Do I want to have a wife and kids someday? The answer is yes. I'm not paralyzed. And so I can't have children and all that stuff. But all my muscles are affected. And there are different types of cerebral palsy. And I have spastic diaplegia. But like I said, I don't believe I'm going to have that for very long, because I believe in the healing power of Jesus. And if you don't know Jesus, I would encourage you to get to know him. I hope you do. Check out Romans 10:9-10. Because without knowing God, you can't truly know his plan for you. So say this prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me my sins. I make you my Lord, my Master, my Savior, my friend. Help me to live and live by your truth and your word. And if you'll do this for me, I'll serve you all the days of my life. And if you prayed that prayer with me, congratulations. You made the best decision possible you could ever make. And when I come to speak to you or your organization at your event, if you would like to know more about my faith, that's another session where I go deeply more into my faith. Like I said, I speak all kind of voices, so I'm well aware of what I can and can't say in certain voices, and I tailor my presentation to that particular situation. But if you'd like to know more about my faith, I can do that too. All right? And God bless you. Hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for tuning in. And I will talk to you later. Don't forget to hit subscribe and leave your comments at the bottom. God bless. Bye.